Good evening and welcome back to BRidge. I wanted to talk about how the economy worldwide is doing. A strong bellwether for how a economy does is the amount of money that people are willing to spend on advertisement. If one goes by how much people are willing to spend on advertisement, one gets a fair good idea how the economy is doing. Because when people feel that growth is slowing and they have to cut back, the first thing they do is cut back on marketing and advertising. So if advertising declines, then it is very clear that the world is going through a rough patch. When we talk of advertising, the first thing that comes to our mind is Google and its parent Alphabet. Google dominates the online advertisement space. As television and newspapers decline, it is very clear that Google is a strong bellwether for what is happening to online industry, online advertising and the advertising industry generally. In the second quarter results of Google was recently released, and that they told us is very telling. Google did grow business, but grew at the slowest pace over 2 years. Google's revenue grew by 13%. It hit a humongous $69.69 billion. So this is a huge number, very difficult to digest. And the fact is that from quarter to quarter, it has grown only by 13%. This is the slowest growth rate after the pandemic hit quarter. So it is very clear that people are spending lesser money on advertisement. Google has three main divisions which are spurring growth. One is, of course, its search engine, which dominates the world. Then navigation. Navigation means Google Maps. And not only is Google Map, you could go to access directly. There are people like Swiggy, Ola and other people, Uber and Deliveroo, who basically use Google Maps for going to locations. And they are paid every time they use this Google Map. So navigation is big business. And third, even after a big fight off with TikTok, YouTube remains the biggest video streaming platform in the world. Apart from this, Google has invested in cloud, where it is trying to catch up with Microsoft and Amazon. Amazon is the clear market leader, with Microsoft being in second place and Google a poorly placed third. So it is clear Google's main revenue is definitely coming from advertising. A slowdown in growth means that advertising has slumped and people are willing to spend less than what they were spending last year. So this clearly means that the whole world economy is slowing down, because across the globe, Google is selling advertisements. And Google is big in China, India and United States. And there is no place on the world where Google does not sell advertisements. Thus, there is no doubt that business is slowing down across the globe, though one has to disinterpret the data granularly to know which areas are being affected. But what is another thing worrying for Google is its video sharing platform, YouTube, has grown only by 4.8% compared to 14% in the last quarter over the previous year. This means that Google is still losing market share to ByteDance, which runs TikTok. So TikTok is now leading the charge and may catch up with Google YouTube as the primary video sharing website. While Google still dominates the longer duration and the serious content, the frivolous content is now being dominated by TikTok. This is very clear in the revenues earned by the YouTube division, which is only $7.5 billion, which is not extraordinary. Overall, Google's profits has come at around $6 billion. Therefore, Google has made a margin of nearly 10 to 12% in the last quarter. The fact remains that what Google is telling us is that overall the economy is not in a great shape, and the data cloud business for them has grown as to $3.6 billion. But has made a loss of several hundred million dollars. This clearly indicates that Google is burning cash and throwing money in the market as marketing spends to make sure that they catch up with Microsoft and then Amazon. In fact, Amazon, Microsoft has reached out to Google and Oracle to join an alliance to petition the US government to crimp the dominance of Amazon in Amazon's AWS in their data storage space. At this point of time, the antitrust regulation on Alphabet is also being looked up at seriously, where Alphabet has agreed to put a Chinese wall between the team which sells advertisement and its main team. So YouTube needs to ramp up its short videos program, which was introduced to compete with Facebook's Reels and TikTok. The only saving grace for Alphabet at this time is that TikTok is banned in India, a large market, even as I speak to you, thus enhancing the revenue of YouTube. But whether the dominance that Google has in the search engine space will see some will be breached by its competitors is something that we have to wait and watch. But looks like if the current trend continues, the world could definitely suffer from a period of low to negative growth, as ad sales in Alphabet have indicated. Thank you for watching. Be Rich. If you like this content, kindly hit the like button, press the subscribe button and turn on the bell notification. If you do not turn on the bell notification, you will not be notified every time we put out a video. Once again, I thank you for your support to Be Rich. It's a great privilege and honor that so many of you in thousands have subscribed to my channel and have supported me. I have written 2 books in English, The Alchemy of Money and Ordinary Stocks, Extraordinary Profits. These books are published by us and are ready. If you want to procure a copy, send us a message to the WhatsApp number given below and my team would respond to you. If you want an Amazon Kindle copy, you can click the link below. Finally, those who wish to consult with me can send a mail to berichenglish@gmail.com. Once again, I thank you for your support. If you like this video, press the subscribe button of my channel, hit the like button and turn on the bell notification.